The gist was that the man was an idiot to throw so badly. He could have knocked the esteemed umpire's head off. By now, Des and Mike had gathered me up, and Robin was remonstrating with Marcus, in somewhat less colourful language, but with equal vigour. Marcus, red-faced with anger or embarrassment, said all he'd been trying to do was run Des out.
"It was a bad throw, okay? Ball slipped out of my hand, and I'm sorry she's upset. But it was an accident."
"It would have hit her fucking head, man! Didn't you learn anything from Phil Hughes's death? Or perhaps you did?"
Mike yelled. Yes, a cricket ball was hard, a missile. One of the best Australian cricketers of his generation had been killed by a short-pitched ball. Everyone was yelling now. I'd better take control of the match and of myself. Just as I did when I had warring factions in the playground, I held up both hands.
"Enough! We'll talk about this later, but we have a match to finish. Sadly, I can't recall how many you ran, lads. Robin, can you?"
We edged away for a confab.
"I was so concerned I lost count too. But now I really think that big guy saved your life. Whether what Marcus did was deliberate, I couldn't tell. Not to swear in a court of law, either way."
"Like I said, let's worry about that in a minute or two. Let's get this game over. God, there's going to be a fight any moment. Can you trust me on this? I don't think it's in the laws, but it's what I'd do in a kids' match."
"You might want to tell them just that," he said dryly.
"I'm going to, don't you worry." I summoned the captains and spoke to them as if they were six-year-olds. At any other time, it would have been a joy to watch their faces as I told them that I was declaring the last ball dead, that it would have to be bowled again so that both umpires could give it their proper attention.